And so fintech has really driven lots of disruption in banking, insurance, etc. And why is that? Because innovators that are data-led, who are entrepreneurs, have seen how to improve processes or even redefine models in a better way. And as a consequence, banking and finance has been really significantly disrupted and looking at how to change and to become data-led, not just have data. And I think, you know, predictive analytics is one evolution of it, but then AI and machine learning and all the applications can really drive real value in that sector. And then you also look at, you know, retail, online retail, you know, even the not-for-profit sector. You guys will be happy to know Beyond Blue is doing predictive analytics work with an organisation here in Sydney, helping them redesign services for people who have mental health issues as well. So the applications are really very significant. We're seeing high adoption in traditional markets, not just in financial services, but of course in telco, in retail, now energy, utilities, everywhere. There's this application, you know, and looking for how to improve how we go to market. And, you know, I think that one of the most interesting spaces will be not just in the commercial sector, so for us as marketers, thinking about how we engage customers and what they genuinely want, but more broadly as a society, how do we think about this algorithm for altruism as well?
Yeah, thanks for that. And for yourself, Henry?
I think going last is always a tricky one, isn't it, everyone? So I think there's obviously the low-hanging fruit AI as diagnosis tool. We understand that you have a problem early on by using all the signals that we have. I think the, if I can do the same as Chris did and talk about the risks and the benefits at the same time, I think there's a diagnosis, there's optimization, there's then optimization, I think, will move beyond this AB performed the best or performed the best out of, you know, ABC or ABCN. We'll start to get to, well, I can understand these different sort of cohorts at a quite a detailed level, and I would understand that based on your behavior, it's best that I have an intervention created for you that works in this way. And that's a sort of another level up, I think, where we can see I have a deep insight into you, how to talk to you and how to engage. The difference, other differences, I think, from where we are today is in terms of where we're investing and where we can go wrong. So again, I agree with Chris, is that we've got this very high-powered machine that can go wrong very quickly, and we've seen some good fun examples of that, like racist bots. But I think what that talks to is the need to invest in behavioral economists, behavioral scientists, people more of that ilk and people more of the sort of humanities led, as well as the data scientists. So we're going to have a change, I think, from making sure that we've got the right people so that we don't have things like a bot just saying, hey, you're overweight, do you want to do this? It's like, you might be right, but it's not necessarily a good thing to do.